why, do you suppose, are we so fascinated by nudibranchs? After all, they are just snails without shells. I have a theory. We're all a little bit lazy, and nudibranchs are just insanely easy to photograph and video. But of course, there has to be more than just that. They come in all different colors of the rainbow, and that has to be a lot of the attraction. Purple, yellow, white, pinkish purple, and a little bit of everything. The name nudibranch is a mashup of the Latin word nudus, or naked, and the Greek word brachia, or gills. So, naked gills. Dorid nudibranchs, like you see here, breathe through gills that are on the rear end of their body. Aeolid nudibranchs breathe through finger-like appendages on their backs. Nudibranchs have several sensory organs. Their eyes are tiny and only capable of making out dark and light. They have cephalic tentacles on their head that are sensitive to touch, taste, and smell. Rhinophores on their heads, shown here, detect odors. Shape-wise, nudibranchs vary widely, from simple to complex, just plain trashy, or even things inspired by Rube Goldberg. They are sexually hermaphroditic, having both male and female sex organs. Courtship starts with a slow dance, ending up with the two side by side, facing opposite directions. Fertilization of both occurs simultaneously. Afterward, they both lay a large, ornate ribbon of eggs. Size is another variable. They can range from rice grain tiny to foot-long Spanish dancers. One thing that distinguishes nudibranchs is that they are carnivores, eating tunicates, hydroids, and other animal species. There are many sea slugs that resemble nudibranchs, like these head shield slugs, but aren't. Some possess rudimentary shells and are herbivores. This little guy on the move is a side gill sea slug. Football-sized pleurobranchs are also side gill sea slugs. Sacoglossans are herbivorous, mostly eating algae. Perhaps my favorite non-nudibranchs are the sea hares. They have a soft leathery shell inside their body, and they are herbivores, eating mostly seaweed. Flatworms bear a passing resemblance to nudibranchs, but they aren't even close from a taxonomy standpoint. But still, they are colorful and pretty cool. We'll end with this beautiful pair.